reality sleeps far away. And all that.
Life is better alive.
Was my friend seen the opening for Danganronpa the animation specifically, which is relevant to the fact that Ross had presented me with a gift off of Steam, which is Danganronpa 2, Goodbye Despair. Oh joy, I get to play Danganronpa. Yay!
Say goodbye to life, Madhog.
It's not that long.
Oh boy.
Although I wonder if it will fill him with despair.
Well, it's 5 gigabytes of pure joy that I had to put on my poor laptop. So already I'm despairing.
If you think that's despair, think about trying to cram that onto a PS Vita memory card, which costs an absurd amount for a very low amount of memory.
Freaking heck.
Oh boy. Jesus! Okay. I have fulfilled my Jesus quota for tonight, so let's
begin.
Fantastic.
All right. So...
Oh, by the way, I could not think of a cool name for the new city. Really, the only name that came to mind was the Grey Garden.
The Grey Garden?
Okay, but wait, it makes sense. It makes sense, not just because of the game we just played, me and Devar, but because, think about it, it's a beautiful garden surrounded by remains of a dead city and debris, which is grey, supposedly.
Well,
so
it's going to get rebuilt.
It only works for right now.
Fairytopia. Now, how about, better idea, how about we call it Arcadia?
Seriously, guys, poor people have to put these on bumper stickers, you know. Gotta make sure it fits.
Just call it the Kingdom of the Great Titania, I don't know.
You know, at this rate, I might just have to go with gardens at this rate, because I can't think of any cool names right now.
Okay. How about we keep Beachside now for simplicity, because it's been the title of this campaign since 20 million hours ago?
It doesn't How about we call it the name of the place? It can be a symbolic title. That we are on the beach of the life and looking from the side.
Okay, just because of that, I'm calling this town Finland.
We could call it Garden Beach.
Garden Beach.
Garden. It sounds wrong.
Garbage Beach.
My gosh. Okay, never mind.
That's what we have in New Jersey.
Oh,
oh, we could call it the Finnish version of Fairyland, Keijulandia.
What?
Keijulandia. It's a Finnish in Fairyland.
Okay.
It's good last a while on the naming convention. We'll leave it to the dealers, though.
Okay. Yes, naming aside.
Anyway, intro part, Ross.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
We can make a contest out of it to all our subjects.
Yes, in the same way we chose the name for Warren Foster. All 2 people voted for that.
Hey, well, hey, it's still more important than we're getting right now, so... I would say, sure, if you have a great idea for what Beachside should potentially be renamed to, leave it in the comments below. And also, while I'm in announcement mode, for those that are watching this on YouTube...
Announcing!
We try to play Beachside on Saturday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. That's 1 a.m. Greenwich Mean Time, if you are over in the old world. After that...
Get off my yard, you young punks!
If you are unable to catch our live stream, you can watch it the raw, as if it was streamed version on my channel, or a doctored, enhanced version, as Madhog would love to call it, on his channel.
Actually, only you have been calling it that.
Oh, okay.
Well,
so anyway, hold world! Who are you calling hold, you young rapscallion? You punk! You punky punk! Get off my yard, you punky punk!
I want my trifle!
I'm going to take my...
It's 3:30 a.m. on my end.
Yes, I know. Okay, let's
see. About it.
I guess you're my friends or something.
It's 3:30 a.m. Do you know where your children are?
Oh, gosh.
Your children are in my yard! Oh, I'm going to shoot them!
And anyway, quickly going to say, Ross Fairies, DM, myself, Devar, Acheron, Chloe, Madhog, Manny, Demona is Demon... Well, Demonox is Demona, Matty,
no, Mark. Demona is playing Demonox.
Makes sense.
It's the twist. It's the twist. That was the twist all along.
And as I was saying, Matty Mali is Solomon, and you, gentle viewers, Draco Guardian 30 is the viewer. Welcome aboard.
But really, judging by mine and Manny's experience in the previous stream, who's really playing who?
Dun, 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 dun.
It's like as if
we're
characters or something.
Okay, cue the Twilight Zone theme.
Okay. So when last I checked, you were in the first week of March 2001.
We shall watch the news.
We already did that.
No, we didn't. Well, we have to watch for the follow-up
news.
Also, I would like to remind you, dear audience, that we elected a new priest. And she is such a goofball, such a joy to exchange dialogues with, joke around. Definitely, she's fine.
I should mention in the stream as well, just in case I cause any noise, that I have lower back issues right now, so if you hear me moving around or sounding uncomfortable, then I'm just trying to get comfortable. So apologies in future if that bothers anybody.
And if you hear strange sounds from that end, that's because I am being a typical DM and drinking bottled water and or eating cookies while we are playing.
Okay, and if you hear the sound of stabbing on my hand, don't ask any question.
Oh, also, I'm talking a little quieter because I don't know if there's any other people in this building. It's really late here.
And yet, he's the guy who sounds like a serial killer.
anything you want to apologize for, Demonox, in the future?
No, I'm good.
Okay, fantastic.
Awesome. Great. Really?
Okay, so what do you guys wish to do?
Well, I know I need to watch the news first just to see what the follow-up story will be and hope we're not screwed.
Yes, because none of us actually took that seriously at all.
Actually, I was taking it seriously. I just wanted to see what would happen in the next week or two.
Oh, sure.
Improvement or failure?
Also, it doesn't help that there were so many other things that needed doing around here in the church. So
it's almost like someone knocked down a wall recently or something.
Oh, jeez, I wonder what happened there.
Such a mystery.
Yes.
Anyway, sorry about that.
It happens with natural calamities.
Well, I guess Solomon was visiting his mother and has just returned. Is that possible?
Really, I think only 2 weeks elapsed in-game, which this time is not very much. So I basically was saying that you were kind of just in the church doing your own thing.
Okay.
That's right. Good.
And what is his own thing?
Well, actually, I will let him get two actions real quick, because that's the fairest way to do it.
Okay.
Marty, go ahead.
Marty, go.
Okay, so he doesn't know the church actions, because he hasn't been a part of it yet. So your actions are to work for the church, which could increase your reputation and or rank with it. I don't think you can really go much higher than Fae Guard at this current point, but you could still increase your reputation. You could study theology, which can potentially increase your intelligence.
Well, his reputation could go higher if he takes part in one of Manny's plays.
No. Well, no. Reputation could go up, but he can't attain a higher rank. Anyway, he could practice spellcraft, which would reduce the DCs for true magic and help in knowledge of magics. You could train. This would increase your combat attack or defense. You could go out and try to salvage supplies from whatever's left in the ruins of Beachside. That's usually an action most people would not care to do anymore. Or you could assist with construction, which would increase your strength.
I study theology.
So you're going to study theology?
Yes.
Okay, so let's see how your first action goes. Do you get an event? You do not. So you make standard progress, which means that you get plus one to intelligence.
If you'd have been a bot, you'd have got an event.
Yeah, but the thing is, events aren't always positive.
Speaking of which, I'm going to rename Riley Bot to Robo Rye.
You know, I still cannot believe a robot can catch a flu.
The reason I'm calling him Robo Rye is because Neko reminded me of Robo Kai, and that was amusing.
Fair enough. So,
just to be clear, is God evil?
Is God evil?
Yes.
Emphatically,
yes. Your point of view.
The Jody's still out in this campaign, but these guys seem to think so.
And he's the Abrahamic God.
Yes.
Or something.
He is the God that everybody knows, you know, the popular guy that shows up at parties and everybody knows him. Hey, it's that guy. Yay, it's that guy at the party. Yay.
Solomon, best God.
Solomon
also gets a second action for the second week. So you can do any other one of those actions that you would like to do.
I study spellcraft.
Okay. So that will reduce the DC for your magic by one. No event.
Oh, shame.
Yeah. Okay. And it's a dice roll. And that will conclude your 2 weeks of spare time. So
how is my DC counted?
For true magic, which I don't know if you've actually learned yet. Did he learn any true magic? I don't believe he did.
I don't think he's learned any magic because we went off without him.
Correct,
last time.
He hasn't mastered any type of magic yet.
Glib and Force Bolt.
Oh, okay, so that's right, you have those magics from being a fae, so just keep it noted that DC for true magic has decreased by one. You'll find out about later on once you acquire it.
Okay.
Trust me, you're going to get a chance to get it before there's any combat situation. Anyway, so back to the main story.
Back to the main story.
Our top story tonight is fairies are about to get screwed. I mean, meow.
Oh. What was that?
I heard you roll the dice earlier on.
Yeah, you just don't know what it was for.
We're screwed, aren't we?
Oh yeah.
It's war.
Oh gosh.
What is it good for?
Inventing stuff.
It's good for you. It's good for me.
It's good for losing your faith in humanity.
So, also are you turning on the TV to view the news?
I definitely am, yes.
First thing the reporter says is, war. War never changes.
No, that's not what's going to happen.
Except the enemy changes.
So he says, war has changed.
No. You see reports of violence against fairies. Basically, to your knowledge, is only like they're only reporting like three or four specific cases, but they're certainly blowing the coverage as loud as they possibly can.
Wow. Question.
Yes?
Question. Is this turning into that episode of Animatrix in which we explain the backstory of the robotic dominance and accept substitute robots with fairies?
I sure hope not.
That's what...
You know, I mean, technically that could happen if you guys really wanted to get blood hungry.
I mean, the freaking backstory kind of ruins the whole point of the films, because really you have no reason to root for humanity.
Yeah, basically. <at that point. laughs> Like, they just did it to themselves. Mm. Anyway.
It's still better
than things are going bad.
Yeah, we really need to take this a bit more seriously, methinks.
There's some cries from media outlets to see what the organized fairy religion of Beachside thinks about, since that's basically what you more or less put yourself out on the airwaves as.
Yeah, I think we've postponed it long enough. I think Chloe needs to talk about this. To the media.
So your actions are the same, or potential actions for this are the same as before. Oh, by the way, when I'm phrasing these to you, even though I'm doing so in a meta sense, in-game sense, it's basically Cindy advising you on the best actions she can think of.
Your Majesty, has this our religion been registered?
Sorry, I couldn't hear what you're saying, Matthew.
Is this religion registered?
Registered?
I'm trying to think what's registered. You
know, we could get... we need to get people to know about us better.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Cindy says, I think she's saying, are we legally considered a religion? Because I don't think anyone ever filed any paperwork with the government to be considered as such.
I hear the
process is ridiculously lax, but still.
I mean, if Scientology can become a real religion,
some people say if enough people believe in something, it's considered a religion.
Yeah, it doesn't work like that.
It doesn't quite work like that. I think the steps go something like that. You have to incorporate yourself as a non-profit entity first. Then you have to have a dedicated place of worship, which we fulfill. Large number of people that believe one thing that they feel is a truth. Have true faith in something, which I believe we qualify for.
Yes.
And finally, there was like one other thing. Oh, that we have to have some kind of specific ceremony that we do. Which,
And then we get the money.
So, my suggestion is that if we do all that and get some kind of government's approval to all of this, then we can also get our stance better amongst the common people.
Another thing that's good about that is churches are completely non-profit, so basically the government wouldn't be able to touch any of the money that we raise in taxes.
That's the whole reason to found your own religion, really.
Yes, I think we need to do that.
Yes, we need to get the money.
Yes, we need, because first we get the religion, and then we get the money.
Yes, religion plus approval equals profit.
Oh, and a fun fact, you don't even need to incorporate your non-profit organization anywhere near where the church actually congregates at. I heard tale of this one religion that was based in New York and decided to incorporate itself as a non-profit in Texas.
Is it Scientology?
No.
Probably not, no.
No, this is real things that happened.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think I heard about this, but I can't remember what the religion was.
Okay.
The ultimate activation.
Manny says,
it was an online, it was basically a news show basically proving how ridiculously easy it was to set up a scam religion.
Hmm. Hopefully no one will think of that about us then.
I'm just
Manny is writing everything down in a notepad for later peruse.
Yes, and proclaims his wife is the most cleverest woman in the world.
That's exactly what he wanted to say before being interrupted.
Well, sorry. I did go to college.
Hmm. Oh, that's good then.
Yes.
Wow, Manny says, wow, college girls are so hot.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, you.
No.
I think I broke Madhog.
No, I'm fine. It takes a lot more than that. But still, don't try. Jesus Christ, Ross, the fact that you used your normal voice to say that just
can't. I unfortunately am not very good about pitching my voice high or low, so unfortunately it's just my normal voice to play all these characters. I wish I had that type of vocal range.
Neither am I, but I still try to sound like a woman.
I tried to pitch it a little higher, but again, I can't do so very well.
Oh, it's easy, Ross. Well, when in doubt, just go as high as humanly possible. Like so. Hello!
No, that's just obnoxious.
So my fellow fairy social do the paperwork.
Hello, I'm new here.
Okay, let's carry on and stop
besides,
the show.
Besides, I told my voice alone without finding who is attached to is fairly gender neutral.
Anyway, shall we continue without the shenanigans?
So who is going to do the paperwork? Most likely the... Well, it'll have to be someone high up in the position.
Well, Cindy's like, I suppose I could anyway. Do it.
You about to say, Ross?
Cindy says, I suppose I could do it.
Okay, we'll count on you, Cindy.
But you probably have a more pressing matter to contend with right now.
Yes, I think I should probably talk to the media about this.
Either the media or Congress, whichever you feel is going to be more fruitful.
Well, here's the thing. George W. is notoriously Let me say that. George W. is notoriously extremely
religious.
I was going to say bigot, but yeah, it's a Christian bigot of the most extreme variety. So yeah.
That'd be a bush.
Also,
Cindy's
also,
I believe, however, the House and Senate are mostly equal. No one has a significant advantage in either place right now.
Huh. So maybe it might be an idea to skip the media and go straight to Congress, then. In that regard.
In fact, I've even heard tales of a few congressmen or women actually becoming fairies.
Oh!
That's all.
Okay, Ross.
Now this needs investigating.
Ross.
Yes?
Ross. If Hillary Clinton is a fairy,
no!
I swear to God.
Absolutely not.
My gosh.
Fairies actually have to have beliefs. Besides money.
Oh gosh.
Hey.
All right.
I'm probably going to get heat for that one eventually, but I don't even care.
Well, yeah. I mean, we spent a good portion of the previous stream just making political humor all over the place. So,
political humor.
Really?
Anyway,
the part about the victim mosquitoes and building a wall around them was pretty funny.
By the way, Ross, if we were to go to Congress, do we have to go as a party or does a couple of us have to go? Essentially,
You could choose to go however you want, but it's one of those things that the larger the group, the more likely they're going to want to speak to you. Although, again, with maybe just you and your retainers also would be helpful. It depends on what type of message that you're trying to send.
Solomon says, I'm a little concerned about this whole God is evil thing. How are we going to sell that to the people?
Well, the fairy religion doesn't say God is evil.
Yes, we don't say
that's
that.
A personal held belief of you guys after almost getting murdered by an angel.
Yeah. Well, that happened.
I mean, that's kind of like, kind of not still keen on this guy now.
He did send people to try and kill us.
Oh, maybe
I'm just going to say this.
Just some separatist group.
I'm just going to say this here right now. Chloe just judges the angel harshly, not anyone else.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
Yeah, she's a weird one. She likes to judge people as individuals, not as a group or labels.
That's a good mentality to have, but it doesn't work all the time.
Yeah, exactly. That's supposed to be the point. Anyway,
So we go there. We sing America. Fuck yeah!
Let's just praise the country of America.
So first, I need to know how you're going, who you're taking with you.
Let's see. I'll definitely have to take. Let's see. If we're going to get the best out of this, I would need to know whether everyone else be. Let me think how to phrase this question. Who would be wanting to go on this endeavor with Chloe?
Manny raises his hand immediately.
You're a guard.
Ooh. Well, we need a bodyguard, in case.
Well, he's big and intimidating, and he can literally dress as a bodyguard with the snap of a finger, so...
Yeah, as long as...
I have a 14. Cindy suggests that you bring... I have a 14 charisma with plus 10 diplomacy.
What do you say, Ross?
I said, Cindy suggests that you bring at least another fairy with you.
Another fairy?
Fairy rank.
Well, that's Demona. Or one of the other guys.
Yeah, basically, fairies and advisors.
Guys, why are we even playing this game? It's obvious that we're all going to go. Why do you... Hey, no, who am I going to pick to come with me? Maybe this random NPC or this player whose character is part of the party?
We have to leave someone competent in charge while we other are going there.
Well, Cindy is competent.
Yeah,
okay.
And he's like, you should leave Amber in charge.
I'm all
Cindy and Amber.
So. Yeah, I'm Chloe tempted to do so. Actually,
Chloe actually instantly says, "Okay."
No, Chloe. Manny face palms because even for his standards, that's a dumb decision.
You realize that was a joke, right? You really shouldn't do that.
Somewhere Amber's thinking, oh god, don't put anything on my shoulders. No, no, I'm just here to make people laugh. I don't run the place.
So yeah.
Why not? Wait, better idea. Why don't we leave Amber's best friend in charge?
No.
The airhead.
He's gone. Oh, you're the airhead. Okay, yes.
Not the selfish one.
No, the selfish airhead. Left.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You're thinking of the selfish one, Ross.
No, for a second. I forgot. The airhead, yes, I have.
Yes, so anyway, there is one thing I need to do, though, before we leave, that I think is going to be very easy to sort out, because both Riley and Solomon need a bit of something behind their skills. There's certain skills, if you know what I mean, Ross.
Yes, I know what you're saying.
I am a man with a very particular set of skills.
Yeah. So I'm going to quickly dub them as consorts under the circumstances.
Simply consorts. Good for you guys.
Do you want me to stay, Your Majesty?
I think we might need your diplomacy skills just in case we need somebody to sweet talk the
Yes, because Riley thought Riley has been awfully quiet as of late, so he's of no use.
Well, allow me to say this, logically speaking, Solomon and Riley wouldn't be able to get high in the ranks to have much of a say or a wallop behind them, so I have to make them consorts by logical reasoning of that sort of standard.
So does that mean I'm now your mate?
Chloe doesn't want to think
technically.
Technically, yes.
Technically,
really,
yeah,
no.
In title only. But because so,
don't try anything.
Well, thank Titania, because we would have needed to slow down a bit.
I mean, you just met. Buy me dinner first, jeez.
I can imagine Riley being all for it, going like, okay,
like sure, why not?
You know, I've always been, this, you're kind of ruining my Chloe Perdamona fanfiction.
Well, yeah, that could still happen.
Yeah, look, things could still happen. It's nothing romantic's going on here, Madhog. It's just, we need...
A position of availability, just to give them the plot they need for speaking.
Obviously, you do not know the meaning of OTP.
For Manny, not Manny, I mean Matty, I'll give you a brief description of what the Queen's Consort's duties in the church are.
Yeah.
Ish.
Hmm?
Yeah, I can think of one duty they have to perform every night.
Well, that is a duty, but that's not all. Basically, your goal is to basically represent the ideal man in the religion, if that makes sense. So basically, in the religion of Titania, males are subservient to the
females.
And so you'll definitely have to at least play that role. And but still, you can have significant sway as a negotiator or whatnot, because you also have the queen's ear, more or less.
Yeah, essentially, in the upper rankings, you can do upper ranking stuff, but it's more of a type. But the females have last say in the matter.
So essentially, in the outside world, it looks like a very important position. Within the church, you're more or less a figurehead.
Okay, so I need to be my duty is basically to be a role model for little boys.
More or less, yes.
Pretty much.
Please do not say that with that voice that you put on.
Little boys.
I mean, I don't want to say this about the church, but was this a thing in 2001?
Oh, yes.
Actually, yes, it technically was. It just wasn't brought to light.
Haven't you seen Spotlight?
Yes, actually, it was even before 2001. It's been for a good while, yes.
It was just not brought to light until much later.
Gosh.
Yeah. Anyway, so, with that bit of terrible out of the way.
Yeah, so I think Chloe would explain it in the way of the same as I explained it, but except that she would have to tell him the bad news that males cannot get high rank.
And no snoo-snoo.
Yes, this is a
try to lose it.
Wait, so is mating with the queen a duty for consorts?
On the books, is? Yes.
But it's on the table.
Well, on the table.
So let me get this straight. You're like, hey, Solomon, do you want all the responsibility of being a high-ranked member of the church with none of the benefits? Too bad. I'm making you one.
well, what else could I make him?
I mean, it only had... It only had one benefit, and you cannot have that.
I'm very, very sorry.
Well,
Chloe's awkward to write for in this scenario.
Very. Let me get some good laugh.
Indeed. Well, alrighty.
Well, okay, if you say so, Chloe Senpai.
Oh, man.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, so...
To the Congress?
To the Congress! Ta-na-na-na.
Yeah, to Congress.
Yes.
Okay, Miss...
Matthew, stays outside.
Miss Chloe goes to Washington.
And Cindy is in charge while we're gone.
Yes.
Exactly like that. Wait. Yes.
And she's Manny's wife.
Yes,
she is Manny's wife.
Yep, Cindy left.
And she is not insane somehow.
The opposites
attract each other.
Let's say we complete each other. I bring spice to her life. She brings stability to mine.
She brings balance to the force.
She let's just move on.
Yes, let's get going. We need to get to Congress and sort this out.
Okay.
Yes.
It takes you the better portion of a day to fly there.
When the last man he flies.
Oh gosh.
Oh, basically, you have to stay outside.
So we fly with our wings.
Yep.
Yes.
Okay.
No, we fly with our penises, obviously. They are like a shot, like a helicopter. They propel us.
Unfortunately, that leaves half the party behind.
Of course we fly with our wings.
Right, then.
So,
I thought our beloved leader would have used that teleport spell.
Why would she wait? She hasn't been to the Congress.
She hasn't personally been to Washington, D.C.
I thought she was seen a picture or something.
No. That doesn't work like that.
That thing with the picture only works in the film Jumper.
Yes.
That was a terrible movie.
So yes, it was. So you arrive at the... Congressional building. You, of course, are stopped by security before getting in. You tell them who you are and that you wish to have a hearing with Congress.
Oh, gee. I hope the security is Agent Super Bowl.
No.
Maybe we should have called them beforehand.
They are in the middle of a session currently, but they said they actually really do want to meet with you, and that if you could... just wait a couple days. They will be more than willing to have a conference with you.
Guys, let's explore the city. Let's go to Broadway. Let's go to all the other things.
Broadway in Baltimore?
Aren't we in Washington?
No, I'm Washington, D.C. I'm sorry. Sorry. Blah, what am I thinking?
We can fly to Broadway. Really?
So you can fly to New York City? That's going to be quite a flight.
Yes.
Wait, isn't the neighboring city?
No. No. As someone that lives in that general area, by car, that's a 4-hour drive.
But wait. We were originally Maryland. Where is Maryland in relation to Washington?
Maryland is just it's actually north of it. So you're actually going further away from New York City.
Pity that we do not have money to go shopping with.
No, wait. So it took the better part of the day to get from Maryland to Washington, but it takes so much more to get from Washington to New York?
Oh, yes. Maryland is several states away from New York. They're not just right next to each other. Actually, you're far closer as far as major cities are concerned to Philadelphia.
Okay, so what's there to see in Washington?
Well, there's obviously the
Penis Tower,
famous monuments.
Yes, like the Penis Tower,
and Lincoln Memorial, and all kind of war memorials,
the Washington Memorial,
what memorials?
Mostly stuff like that. This is coming from a guy that's never personally been to Washington, D.C., so I can't tell you everything that's there. But yeah, I live relatively close. I mean, within driving distance, I've never gone myself, so I don't know what to say about that.
At some point, go there. Eventually. You go there at some point.
Right.
Well, okay then. So, fellows,
I heard at some point that our citizens complain that there isn't much stuff to do.
That's being rebuilt.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So, yeah, what we're going to be doing for the next couple of days then? Are we going to go?
You know, if it takes an afternoon to get from Maryland to Washington, we could just go back and return the next couple of days and do something else productive over there.
You can, but keep in mind each action usually takes a week. So, I mean, you basically won't be able to do anything super productive. Okay. You could check up on, what's going on with, the church officials you put into place, but that'd be about it.
We can phone them for that.
Yes.
Did anyone even have phones other than the newbies that came by?
It's 2001. There are public telephones. They are still a thing.
Yeah, public telephones all over the place.
Yeah. We're still good on that one.
Yeah,
also got telepathy, technically.
Yeah, true, actually. We do have telepathy.
Yes, we do have the telepathy.
You have telepathy. You have a lot of things. Keep track of them. Chloe, please, for the love of God, do not turn into Twilight Sparkle. You forget your own powers.
Who is Twilight Sparkle?
He does a lot.
Okay, this was out of game.
Everyone's just having fun.
Okay, I'm having fun. Look how I'm having fun right now.
The moment I take Chloe shopping, I have money.
Twilight Sparkle the group would be a perfect fairy name.
Okay, Chloe could go shopping, however, there's not really much to find. You basically have every spell that you can get at this stage of the story. The only one that's severely limited on spells is the new player.
Oh. Someone needs to go shopping.
Does he have money? How much money does he have?
I believe he started with $300, if I recall.
Okay, so in the meantime, what Manny will do is find a place to sleep for the next couple of days. Because, we kind of need to find a place to sleep.
That's kind of a good thing, yes.
Yes, we need some place to stay, to be safe and sound.
So, any preferences? Bridges? Abandoned buildings?
Can we just go to a hotel?
With what money?
Oh, you don't have money?
No, I don't have a dime. I have a dollar. I have $1.12. Speaking of which, are there any milkshake shops?
Yes, there are.
By the way, Ross, how much money Solomon has from his car sailing businesses?
I think it was $300 I had you start with. I asked you to record it.
Okay, yeah. $300.
So Chloe has about $39.50 to her name.
Well, perhaps we should have prepared better for this journey. Just saying.
Well, we've
been gathering
this.
This is the worst. This is the worst the entourage.
Worst, the worst planned trip ever.
This is the worst entourage ever.
Accommodations for a bit.
Do we have anything to sell?
Anything to sell? You have your spell components, really.
Okay, I have an idea. Manny just had the best idea.
Oh god.
He would change his appearance into one of a generic street performer, and he would perform in the streets, soliciting people to give money for his performances.
That's actually a pretty good idea.
That is a good idea.
As many as his moments.
That is going to take all day for you, but we can see what you earn.
You don't know if you could claim to talk to the diplomatic people and get an accommodation for them.
That is such
they are here
a good
as
idea.
Diplomatic people. They are here on diplomatic purposes.
That so is also a good idea. Stuff. That is a better idea. That might actually make my own plan pretty worthless.
They're basically not willing to put you up for right now. Because the state, the validity of your particular religion is being called into question.
Well, back to plan. Make money fast.
Okay, so for an entire day's worth of performances, Manny is able to make $60.
That's better than nothing.
Yeah, definitely. Now we have 61.12.
Yeah, that's my. Don't forget, though, milkshakes are more expensive in the capital.
Yeah,
and
well,
don't forget the $300
I have. I'm only going to buy milkshake in the day of the actual Congress entrance. You know, in case something could go wrong, I have one additional point in constitution.
I guess okay. I got to call my nurse and play mini golf.
Okay, well, as you were about to do that, you feel actually a strong urge to visit a sporting goods store instead. You don't know why.
He's a sportsman.
Go buy stuff.
Meanwhile, from a distance, you can hear "When the Last Man He Flies." That's his performance.
Oh God!
Yeah, Damone and Chloe are just trying to get sort of things sorted.
Okay.
Yeah, I assume that would be the case.
So you will go into the sporting goods store. I actually have a location for this from way back when the campaign started. I think.
Hey.
Do I have a sporting goods store? Of course I didn't. Because of course, why would I?
Nope. I was looking at the listings. They've actually said that. I just gave them a store.
Nope. Because no one needed a sporting goods store. Oh well.
Make one up.
Well. I'll get pictures for stuff like that later, I guess. So you...
You go to a sporting goods store.
Yes, so you go to a sporting goods store. I don't have an image.
Insert name here.
Yes.
It's
going to be Dick's. Dick's Sporting Goods.
Dick's?
That's a real sporting goods chain that exists in America.
Dick's Sporting Goods.
Most likely a nickname for Richard.
Mm.
Yeah, but still.
I feel sorry for all the Richards.
You could have called yourself Rick's. Sporting goods store.
Nope, Dick's.
Anyway, go shopping.
You go in there, and four particular clubs catch your eye.
Ooh.
Four clubs.
Yes. These particular clubs fill you with strange feelings that you've never felt before.
Wait, when you say clubs, you mean golf clubs or medieval maces?
No, golf clubs.
Medieval maces in a sporting goods store.
That'd be amazing. Because there's not a lot of variety in mini golf putters, so to speak.
Because it sucks!
I'm going to just say they're all different colors so you can tell them apart. And also, they can be used as an improvised weapon if you need to as well.
Unless you break them, that's bad.
However, yes, you do risk breaking the club by doing that. So only attempt to use a club as a weapon if you're desperate.
Last resort.
Solomon.
This is going to give you four spells.
Nice.
Solomon, you play golf. Are you the 1%?
I play mini golf.
Oh. The better kind of golf.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the poor
man's golf. Hey, we want to go for that.
Oh, yeah, mini golf, the poor man's golf. Yes.
Real golf is boring.
Real golf kind of destroys entire environments.
Mm. I live close to one.
So
your four spells, unfortunately, one of these are going to be redundant, but there was no way of me knowing why I made this that you were going to become a fairy right away. So you basically have a club that gives you the glib spell, which you already have.
Oh.
It's unfortunate. You don't have to buy that one. I'm not going to force you to, but that was an option in case you did not transform into a fairy all the way right away. And so, you still want magic stuff. Okay, so the second spell that you get is Charm.
Charm?
Yes, okay. You can charm one person. This makes them interpret you as a friend and will take actions as you would with any normal friend.
Handy in combat.
If you take any type of action that is threatening, however, it immediately breaks the spell. And it only works on a human. It will not work on a monster.
Ah, you only have charm person, not charm creature.
Yes, you cannot. No matter how much you want to, you cannot flirt with a mind flayer.
Does it also work on fairies?
It does work on fairies, yes. However, fairies are highly resistant to non-true magic. At least ones that have realized how fairy magic works.
You know, I just realized there are a couple of spells that I have never actually bothered to use.
Yeah, same here, actually.
Yes, one of them... Well, you have a million spells you have not bothered to use.
She can't use them all.
One of them is charm, because I thought, actually charming people. I mean, I kind of charmed those two bodyguards all the way back in episode 3 or 4. And the other one is the speed spell, the gonna go fast. I never used that.
Yes.
Okay. There are two more clubs.
Yes.
It's two more clubs.
So the next one gives you command. Command allows you to issue one specific command to a subject, and that subject has to make a attempt to make a save against it. This command cannot be anything that would immediately inflict harm upon them. For example, you couldn't
to drop weapons.
Correct. You could not force someone to, say, stab themselves with the knife that they are holding. You could command them to drop the knife that they are holding.
Not bad for disarming.
You can also have them do an action that they are not aware is dangerous or suicidal.
Run forward into fist.
Yes, or investing money in a condo. It's real estate.
It's real estate affairs.
And your final weapon, your final club, which gives you the spell, gives you basically the same spell that Manny just got, unlimited conjure weapon. So basically that allows him to, you can conjure a number of thrown weapons equal to the number of enemies that you have and toss them all in a single turn. So it allows you to basically make melee attacks at range.
Can it conjure bullets?
So
it can,
now,
but it cannot conjure guns.
So now three people have that same spell.
I haven't
even bought the clubs yet.
Well, I mean, these are each club costs $50. Obviously, you would only buy three of them because you're not going to spend money on a replica of the spell that you have in bread.
Yeah, $150.
So, what are the colors of the clubs?
The colors of the clubs.
Pick ones. Pick a color.
Okay. Charm is a light blue.
Okay.
Command is a light green, and conjure weapon is a light purple.
Okay, sounds neat.
I don't know whether to applaud you, Matty, for this, just because you're being so invested in this, or whether I should think this is like the most mind-numbing thing I'm hearing.
It's incredibly important. If he doesn't know what color it is, he could be accidentally grabbing the wrong club. Mm-hmm. I'll use command.
That's why they have to be color coded.
And what was the conjure weapon?
What was that?
Conjure.
What was the conjure weapon?
It was light purple.
Okay.
So Matty has conjure range weapons that are group.
Yes.
Well,
and Demona has conjure melee weapons.
Yes.
Yeah, so they're specialized in that regard, while Manny has both.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's almost that was done intentionally.
Well, I still have my gun, so do I really need a conjure weapon spell?
But you only have you could make do the conjure weapon thingy, because you said you could conjure the bullets.
You could use the bullets
for your gun.
Oh, you take them? Okay. Well, I buy all three of them.
Okay.
Could he actually conjure ammunition for his weapon?
He could, but it's probably going to be more effective to throw them than shoot with the gun. That's how this gun works.
Well, either way, he's still keeping the gun from what he said, that it's
bumper guns.
It can surprise a demon when you suddenly put a gun and try to shoot it like a normal human would.
Oh, you'll break the gun habit soon enough. Everybody else in the party did.
Yeah. Well, Chloe hasn't. She never touched a gun in her life.
No,
Because that Lamia taught everyone, guns are not the best weapon.
No, the backpack, unless it's a soft target with low armor, the guns are practically worthless.
You remember how I told you the gun has a cap of 3 damage?
Yes.
Yeah.
Most enemies have armor of 5 or better.
Oh.
So it's only useful against normal people.
Essentially, yes.
Don't try it on a monster. I shall shoot the dragon! Pink!
Are there any humans who serve demons directly?
You do not know that.
You don't know. Okay. But if we're fighting a human or a thug, it's handy because they have fleshy, they have squishy bodies, and you can shoot
Ross,
them.
Yes,
can
Manny?
Can I kill something? At this point in time, I would wage war against pigeons. Really?
You want to fight that bad?
I have all these new abilities I want to try out. We haven't done anything of the sort in a long while. It feels like forever.
I buy all the clubs, so I have $150 left.
Okay. Well, let me put it this way, Manny. Depending on your actions, you may get your chance. Sooner rather than later.
Within reason, of course, I would assume.
Oh, boy.
We want to have fun, too.
Yeah, the for the whole party, not just for Manny.
I'm not talking about for Manny alone.
Oh, no.
But of course, there are actions that you can take that may potentially change how things are going to outcome. I never, ever put players in a situation where an event is predetermined and you can't ever change that will go off.
Fluffy bottoms.
Not in a video game, for example.
Well,
no, fluffy bottoms.
Yes, fluffy bottoms. Well, there was an actual choice there.
There was.
Yes, it was a really very heavily piloted choice, but still, it was a Mass Effect choice, basically. Let's face it.
Question: If I use these gloves as a weapon, how much they do damage?
Your gloves as a clubs as a weapon, they give you +1 to your attack.
Yeah. Okay.
Lightweight.
And that's right, he still hasn't had a chance to figure out how combat itself works.
No. Hey, he's always free to ask one of the moment.
Well, it would be best to figure out how it works with a live combat. Would you not agree?
It depends up to you entirely?
Okay. Also, keep in mind that since you have left the area of sorry, Beachside, the area is again quite cold as it is very early March versus
I'm dressed properly.
Tropical weather in Beachside. You think sleeping on the street will you'll probably come close to freezing to death, if not do so.
It's almost as if somebody should have tried to earn some money today.
Do we have some cheap motel where we can go?
Yeah, can we stay somewhere?
You can attempt to get a room at a cheap motel.
Oh, I have an idea.
What?
Okay, one of us could get a room in a cheap motel for one person, and then it would let everyone else come in from the window. It will be a really, really short space, but for one night, we can manage.
That would be really difficult, I would assume.
Most hotels don't really
give a good impression to the Congress.
No. Well, okay, then. That would save a lot of money, then, I guess, if we can pull this off.
Okay, so...
Why is Manny the one who's having all the smartest ideas?
Because you're the most streetwise out of the group.
Yeah.
You know what? That makes sense.
Why? She's just used to working in different circles.
Damona is wise when it comes to set up killing spots and training on her lonesome. What does she know about street life, really?
The thug life, y'all.
Thug life, y'all. Thug
life. Chloe's too straight-laced for any of that.
Okay, so you're able to find a quote-unquote roach pit in town. However,
I hope it's literally called the Roach Pit Motel.
It's not called the Roach Pit Motel, but it's called the Comfort Suites Hotel.
Which... I don't like the looks of this place.
I bet. Okay, the sea of comfort falls on us, narrowly missed us.
Okay, so the rate per night is $119.
Did you just say rate per night?
Yes,
rate.
Okay, good. Damona, you should go in, buy a room because you have many money apparently, and then let us in from the window.
Okay.
And please, Damona, chica, for the love of God, try to not look conspicuous, please. That's all I ask.
Damona finds the store clerk then. Well, store clerk, the receptionist.
Okay.
Give me a room or I'll kill you!
Yeah, I can imagine it now. He's like, Damona just goes and goes like, "Hello, good sir. Lovely weather having today. Now, give me a room, I'll kill you."
What does Damona actually do?
Yeah,
room or die.
Damona approaches the window. She uses her own glam spell to do a quick wardrobe change.
Okay,
so to speak. Approaching in, as she comes to the window to look like a slightly posh end person. As she walks in, goes, "Excuse me, sir. I was wondering if I could perhaps get a room for the night. I wish to meet a friend here later, if you get my meaning."
I certainly do.
Slowly sliding the money over.
That was not the plan. You should have not said that. He or she will make you pay for both of you.
Just keep in mind that if there are we require to hold your identification here, and that if there are any damage to the rooms afterwards, bill you accordingly.
Oh, that's not a problem. Pulling out an ID.
Okay.
With the ID saying Miss Elizabeth Swift.
With Miss. You have Miss in your ID name.
Nice.
Okay.
I mean, you can have that.
Yes, it is actually on the IDs. You do actually get that.
Okay, that's classy.
So he just looks, "I don't see any problem here. Okay, have fun. Just don't break anything."
Okay. Oh, I promise we'll be on our best behaviour.
You should.
Yeah, a little nod as he takes the key and walks off.
And he also says, bloodstains are extra.
Oh, gosh.
You know, she finds the room, contacts Chloe.
Chloe, this is the last time I'm at the moment.
You're going to have to come up to the second floor.
Yeah,
so I don't know if you know how the second floor, but yeah.
Yeah, so we can fly into the we can fly through the window then.
You don't need to fly through the window.
Well, it's the second floor, you said.
Yes, there's a door on the second floor.
Just come around the side.
Just go in the door.
Right. It's just I assumed that when Madhog said we use the window, then and you said second floor.
I don't know how.
Are you going to Kool-Aid Man the window?
No. I'm just going to open up the window.
It does. Manny's paying for it.
Open the window. I'm going to pass through the window that's already open. I don't know how hotels are structured in that style of the town.
Wait. Let me get this straight. Second floor, the ground floor?
No, second floor
is the first story above that.
First story floor.
That means I should have to fly because it'll be higher
than the... Fly up to the bloody balcony and come in for the damn door.
Get into the room.
So let me get this straight. This cheap hotel actually has a balcony.
Oh, yeah,
it's not necessarily a balcony. It's a there's a second floor that has a line of doors in front of it, along with like a cement outcrop in front of it, with a railing and everything, so no one would fall.
And let's face it, only two of you actually have to sneak in, considering they're waiting for us. I've already informed them there's a bloke coming.
Okay, yeah, so... and who's going to be that bloke?
I would say Manny.
I was thinking of him.
Manny could walk in if he feels like it that way, but he'd already decided to go in for the window.
Yeah, you know what? Let's go the easy way for once.
Doors are your friend.
I don't forget, Chloe can turn invisible, so it doesn't really matter if she walks through the damn thing or not.
So doors
technically,
are
I could have walked in invisible.
You know what?
I could have sneaked the key.
Okay, guys, Manny's plan was brilliant, and you should acknowledge that. Because I didn't see you coming up with anything more intelligent beforehand, so, yeah.
I tried it as a position with the diplomatic services.
Yeah, that did not work.
Okay, well, so I'm going to assume all of you get into the room. Somehow.
Yes. Get into the room, for God's sake, yes.
I kind of want to know what happens when Manny goes in. Says hello to the clerk. I'm expected above.
Do you really
the guy
do that?
Shrugs.
Do you really
do you have
do
ID?
That?
Do you have ID?
I should have ID.
Last time I checked, you didn't have ID.
You don't have a thing. Don't forget, you have no clothing at one point, and you ran away with your house.
Okay. So why is man? Okay, in that case. Fucking. Solomon, you're the one who comes in regularly, okay? Then he comes in from the door.
Well,
why are you spending so much time
go.
On this?
I don't know.
What is going on here?
I've already basically outright told you it doesn't matter. Just get in the freaking room.
We are in the room.
What now?
Thank you.
Are we happy?
So. Yes. Inside this room, it's a one room with a bathroom. The accommodations are dark, dingy, and not terribly clean. What looks to be fairly ancient looking TV that has HBO. It is in color, and the hotel even proudly advertised that fact out front.
Okay. Hey guys, remember the time in which Beachside turned into Seinfeld?
And there is one bed in this room.
How big anything?
Is this bed? Be a standing bed.
Does anything good come from the TV?
It does have standard cable as well as HBO.
Have the watch news then while here.
I mean, the Game of Thrones was not out yet in 2001, so what's there to watch on HBO?
Sopranos.
Sopranos was just coming on.
And Six Feet Under.
I don't think Oz was on at that point. I think that was a little later. I might be wrong, though.
Stargate SG-1?
Mostly what HBO was known for in that era was having movies after they were released on video, but like, so basically you could watch movies on there without having to buy them on video or DVD.
Okay, I want to...
In fact, that's what HBO stands for. Home Box Office.
I want to push my luck with the dice, and I want to roll for The Last Unicorn.
The Last Unicorn is not on HBO.
Okay, what is there on HBO? What production houses actually
broadcast? It's usually basically big budget movies that were in theaters, usually the previous year. So basically you could find most things that were released in the summer of 2000 on there currently. So basically when the campaign began.
Yeah.
Okay.
My memory is not serving me as to exactly what came out in the year 2000 movie-wise. Okay. But...
Yeah, me too. I mean, what came out in 2000?
Don't look at me.
I think Titan A.E.
Gladiator.
The Gladiator, I think, was 2002.
That's actually 2000. I know this because I... have all the Best Picture Oscar winners almost.
Okay, can I roll for Titan AE?
Yes,
no,
you can.
Gladiator did come out in 2000, so.
What do I roll? What do I roll for Titan AE?
Titan AE is in fact one of the movies playing today.
Yay! Let's watch one of the worst films by Don Bluth. Yay!
Yeah, we'll let the child watch the movies while the adults discuss things.
Okay, first of all, screw you. This was my plan.
HBO does not have any Disney movies on it.
No.
Disney has their own premium channel for that.
Second of all, cartoons are for everybody.
Yes, cartoons are for everyone. And you should know that, Demonox, since you watch them too.
I know.
Thank you, Chloe, or Davar, or whoever you are.
Thank you, person talking on the other side of the screen.
I'll just call me Deloy, then.
I
haven't seen this movie. What it's about?
It's really cool. It's about aliens destroy planet Earth. And actually, you know what? This film is terrible, but let's make fun of it.
Okay.
Chloe's looking enthralled by the unusual style the movie goes for.
I mean, can you believe this? Okay, I imagine a scene which we cut at the end of the film, and I say, can you imagine they call the new planet Earth Planet Bob? How stupid is that?
I guess it's supposed to be comedy.
I am not laughing.
Oh, good
lord. Yeah, this movie was kind of blah.
Okay, also, so by this point, it's getting quite late.
The CGFX looks absolutely ghastly. 10 years from now, they will look dated.
Okay, so...
The troll in Central Park is still worse.
Can't believe we are reviewing a Don Bluth movie in the middle of the campaign!
That's what I'm wondering. Can we please continue?
Next up is Dungeons & Dragons!
Yay!
The cartoon series or the movie?
The movie. That was released in 2000 as well.
That's not quite as good. That sounds good. That would be much better for the movie.
Ceramic Irons, how low you have stowed.
This is the symbol of the fall of Western civilization. Right here, with this guy going...
Wait, is that... Is the two place Queen was in American Beauty?
American?
I guess she was.
American. No, no, no. What do you think? Kevin Costner was in American Beauty. This guy was. I don't even remember where he was in, but he was not American Beauty.
I was still talking about the Queen character. Who, out of character, I have to say that it's Thora Birch who was in American Beauty.
You are not expecting me to remember what who plays in Dungeons and Dragons the movie, are you?
No.
It's been a long time.
Jeremy Irons, Thora Birch, Damon Way, and some other people.
I only remember Jeremy Irons and one of the Wayans brothers because Wayans brothers are always a guarantee of awfulness.
Except in Requiem for a Dream.
So, I think it's getting late now.
It's getting quite late by this point.
Oh, yeah.
Really, the only redeeming part of Requiem for a Dream, the only memorable part is the soundtrack.
Chloe's gonna send everyone to bed now, like the good teacher that she is.
But we are riffing the bad movies.
The moment is asleep on a chair near the window. Near the front window.
Okay, so it is a single chair in here.
So yes. best episode of Seinfeld or what?
This campaign has turned into Seinfeld, yes. Where everything has been made more complicated by everyone's misunderstandings of each other.
It's a sitcom, what do you expect?
Yeah. Anyway, so Demona sleeps on the couch. Who takes the bed then?
I do.
Well, you will have to share it with Manny.
I guess I can manage that.
So the Manny fairy likes, queen is left with the ground.
Yeah.
I have to say...
that seems right.
As the consort thinks consort, keep Manny out of the bed.
Hey, yeah. Hey, Miss Pope! Yeah, you can sleep on the ground. I'd take the bed!
Humility from her.
The only right thing to do is Manny takes, actually forces Solomon out of the bed and gives the bed all to Chloe. We sleep on the floor.
Fine.
Yeah,
Chloe can now teleport home.
I had to warn you, Sally, my friend. I like to cuddle.
Yeah, Chloe basically thanks them, but she also is all like, you didn't have to give it up just for me.
Too late.
Leave it at that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'd still like to go to bed, but
you're not sleeping with the queen. Not on my watch.
Hey, I'm a cohort. Yep, it's one of my duties.
Hey, hey, hey.
And then somebody's okay. Then Demona starts snoring really, really loud. No, Chloe starts snoring really, really loud because it's funnier that way.
Because Chloe sleeps like a drunken snores like a drunken sailor.
And no one else sleeps during the entire night.
Oh god.
Okay.
I just take my shirt and put it on in my ears so I don't hear.
Probably.
So let's roll for Ross.
Mona's used to sleeping rough, so she doesn't care what was going on around her.
Ross,
okay. So what am I
want
roll?
You to roll for that.
Roll for Chloe snoring?
Roll for we all sleep tonight, or some of us don't, and if we have a nice peaceful rest, or if Chloe snores like a dragon.
Demona's sleeping, but she's got one eye on the window.
Of course she has.
Okay.
It's a skill.
Everyone falls asleep. There are nothing keeping anyone awake. Despite the relatively uncomfortable sleeping arrangements, you also having wandered around a city in the cold and flew in the cold most of the day, you guys are all pretty freaking exhausted.
Yeah.
Factoring that fairies have lesser of a constitution than humans, you also have to keep that in mind, too.
Well, that's not Manny's problem.
So how many days before we get to see the Congress?
Hold on. Well, need you to, Demona, I need you to roll a perception or wisdom, or if you have both, combine them.
Okay.
And I need to roll what now?
No, this is Demona specifically.
Me. Okay. Not you. Give me a second. Just going to set this up. I have no perception. It's a bit odd, really.
Yeah.
Strange.
Yeah, well, strange. Even my first thing, I thought I'd get at least perception. 17, though. So I didn't do too bad.
It's pretty good.
Okay, I mean, best role if I had a perception to go with it.
Okay, so as you're just kind of drifting between the being awake and asleep, as you often do, you sleep very lightly due to reasons. You hear a faint noise that immediately startles you awake because of your superior training.
Yep. Superior training.
Yep, that's our Demona, right?
Can I, Demona glances out through the wind, literally pulling, just slightly pulling one of the curtains open. Not enough to see theme, just enough so you can see down the corridor, down the main thing.
Second perception check? Yes, same perception check.
Okay. I've already heard it, so I'm already awake, so I'm not going to catch me off guard in that sense.
So you also, it was faint, so you also might be thinking your mind is playing tricks on you. It wouldn't be the first time something like that has happened due to your mild paranoia.
Hey, I love this. I love my dice roll. I got the exact same roll.
Okay. So you look out the window and you do not see anything that looks suspicious.
Well, I'm not going to be sleeping just yet. I'm going to be keeping my eyes open for a bit. At this point, I'd like to use her spell.
Which spell?
Shadow Blade, as I'm calling it.
That's the conjure weapon?
Yeah, her conjure weapon.
Okay.
To conjure up a small, a bit like a tomfa thing, but with a sharper end, blade at the end of it.
Okay. Well, as you do that,
I can keep her fairly hidden.
Okay, well, as you do that, you do naturally glow because of how spellcasting works for a fairy.
Good thing I've got curtains closed.
Okay,
unless it's doing one hell of a glow, no one's going to notice. Also, how much does this room cost me again?
It's
my money.
It was $119, I think, but it's also you think it's grossly inflated in price.
Okay, I'm going to rob this guy afterwards.
Because of its location.
So. Yeah, I'm going to rob afterwards, so that's fine by me.
Okay, so...
I'm going to get my money back.
Okay, so let's see. There's one more dice roll I have to do. Really? Okay. So, surprisingly, you hear someone rather loudly tampering with the lock to the room. You surmise they may be trying to pick it.
Oh my gosh. Seriously?
Oh my gosh, really?
Yep. It's happening.
It's happening. Demona does not sit directly in front of the door. Go in front of the door. That's stupidity.
Everyone else can. Actually, let's see. I will.
Anyone else awake?
Each in turn to see if they wake up.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a success for Chloe. Chloe heard that. Solomon heard that. Wow, everyone heard that.
Hey.
These motherfuckers, they fucked up so hard here. I can't believe this.
So they're like, come on, open you stupid son of a door. I'm gonna open you. I'm gonna open you, and I'm gonna rob you.
Eventually, the door swings wide open.
Freeze, this is a robbery!
And you see, five men quickly file into the room, guns drawn, all dressed in black garb.